Maka.
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called...
Hey, Molly, where's Dutch?
Well, however it goes.
I'm not sure all that line of thought serves you or me very well.
That's because, Cowpoke, you are a man of profoundly limited intelligence.
No doubt.
Well, you and the old man and Dutch have been running around, digging us ever deeper into shit. Old Mr. Pearson might have gone and lightened the load a little.
Pearson!
Ain't you curious?
I guess.
Gentlemen.
Dutch, you tell him, fat man.
It's peace, Dutch. The O'Driscolls. I mean, I think there's a way.
What on earth are you talking about?
Get the words out properly, fat man.
I met a couple of the O'Driscoll boys on the road in the town. And things were about to get ugly. But you know how I am in a fight, huh? Like a corner tiger. Anyway, somehow it didn't, but we got to talking, and they suggested a parlay to end things like gentlemen.
Gentlemen. Combe O'Driscoll. Have you lost your minds?
You're always telling us, Dutch, do what has to be done, but don't fight wars ain't worth fighting.
They want a parlay? It's a trap.
Well, of course, it's probably a trap, but what do we got to lose finding out?
Get shot.
We ain't getting shot because you'll be protecting us. It's a trap. You shoot a lot of them. If it ain't a trap, that's slim chance.
I don't see the point in any of this.
It's a chance you've got to take.
I killed Combe's brother a long time ago. Then he killed a woman I loved dear.
As you say, it's a long time ago, Dutch.
Let's go. You and me, with Arthur protecting us, no one else.
What about me?
This ain't the time for tigers, my friend.
Mount up then, Morgan. Let's go then.
Hit him! Ah. You know, I've been fighting Combe for so long now, I can barely remember a time when it was different.
You're still fighting him now. Make no mistake of that.
Here he goes, Doubting Thomas. Is there any plan you ain't sour on?
Well, maybe you're right. Just nervous. Let's not waste any more lives needlessly.
I ain't costing lives here. I'm saving them. What did you say? Coming after us.
Because of Blackwater. Oh.
And Leviticus Cornwall and his private army. Then who knows when this local hillbilly thing will come to a head, hmm? Can we really afford to be fighting on all these fronts? And O'Driscoll.
There is wisdom in that.
I hope so, gentlemen, but... like I said, I'm nervous.
Look, you ain't even going to be the one in danger. We'll get on over there, find a nice perch for you to settle into. You got that rifle, don't you?
Yeah.
Then me and Dutch walk right in to the lion's den. With you to cover us, hmm?
Okay, just keep calm, unless I give you a reason not to.
Oh, we'll be fine. We got you.
I will do my best.
Oh, my dear and trusted friend, with you watching over me, I would walk into hell itself.
As... Hey, up there. Men on the ridge.
O'Driscoll's, from the look of them.
I don't like having eyes on us.
We're close. You'll be the eyes soon enough. Maybe he's right, Dutch. Maybe I have pushed too hard. Got us into situations that could have been safer. I see all those mouths we gotta feed, and I dream too big, caring too much. That's my problem.
Caring too much? There's no such thing.
This is horse shit from both of you.
It might be. Micah might be full of shit. Colm O'Driscoll might be full of shit. The promise of this great nation, men created equal, liberty and justice for all, that might be nonsense too, but it's worth trying for. It is worth believing in. Can't you see that, friend?
I don't know.
Try. All I ask is you try.
All right, cowpoke. You're gonna peel off up ahead. We'll be meeting down on the plain. Find a spot just above us where you can keep an eye on things.
All right. However this shakes out, let's aim to meet back at the fork in the road afterwards.
We'll be there, partner.
Hello, Dutch. It's been a while.
Sure.
So, how's your gang doing? They still believing in you? Better world. Pure world. How's that coming along?
Just fine.
How's that score you stole off us?
Which one?
Oh, I like that. It's like I said, this is a charismatic leader. A lot of heat on us this time. Both of us. Whole heap of trouble. They offered me a price, Dutch, to bring you in.
Why didn't you take it?
Well, still might.
I am sorry about your brother.
Yeah, well, I never liked him much.
I liked Annabelle.
You always loved the ladies, Dutch Vanderlyn. I like that about you.
What are we doing here, Colm? Is this thing over?
Got a sense.
Handing him over to the lots. I don't know. Strange times.
They killed Seamus. Fuck the whole lot of them. With this fella Colm's right, we can draw them all back.
True.
He's escaping! Shoot him! Relax. I got him.
Did I kill you?
Not yet.
No, of course not. Not yet.
But I will.
Put his weapons over there!
Morgan, it's good to see you.
Hello, Gomp.
How's wound?
I hardly feel it.
You will. Septic, ain't nice. Now, tell me, fine gun like you, why are you still running around with old Dutch? Could come ride with me and make real money.
It ain't about the money, Colm.
No, no. It's Dutch's famous car. You killed a whole bunch of my boys. Six-point gag.
I ain't got no clue what you're talking about.
Oh, you lie, my friend. And I thought Dutch preached truth.
Let me go, Colm, and end all this crap between you two. We all got real problems now.
The way I see it. They get him. They forget about me.
They ain't the forgetting sort. If I were you, I'd run as soon as I had the money.
Oh, I know you would. But see, we lure an angry Dutch in to rescue you. Grab all of you and hand you in. Then disappear.
So you only met with him to grab me?
Of course. He's gonna be so mad. He's gonna come raging over here. And a whole lot of you. And the law will be waiting for him. Arthur. Arthur. I missed you.
In a minute.
What the hell?
What's he still doing down there? It's one thing torturing a man, it's another thing putting him through stories of the homeland. He better hurry it up. I don't want to be here when the law comes for that side of beef.
Yeah.
he still doing down there? It's one thing torturing a man, it's another thing putting him through stories of the homeland. He better hurry it up. I don't want to be here when the law comes for that side of beef.
My dear boy, what?
They got me. I got away.
Yeah, you did.
Miss Grimshaw, I need help. Reverend Swanson.
He's gonna set the law on us.
No, of course he was.
I'm sorry, Arthur.
It is a bit late for apologies. Swanson!
Mr. Morgan, you're safe now.
Oh, let's get him to bed.
You are safe now, Arthur.
I got you.
You're safe now.
That's pretty, Tuss. That's real pretty.
Miss Grimshaw, will you sit with him a while?
Of course. You'll be okay, Mr. Morgan. You're home.
I thought I'd be burying you, Mr. Morgan.
Well, not quite yet, Reverend.
Good. How you feeling?
About the same as you.
I'm sorry to hear that. Well, take care of yourself.
You too.
We're stuck in the ship now, Mr. Morgan. In the ship. We're drowning in mud.
For a man of the cloth, you have quite a way with words.
Words are the very least of my problems. The very least.
I'm sure.
He just wandered in. Hi, my friend. Hi.
Well, then he's ours, I guess. For now.
Aww. That's so great. Hey, boy. Hey, boy. Aww. What should we call him?
Well, he's a wanderer. He probably did something bad. Kane. His name is Kane.
Okay. Whoa. What did Kane do?
A real bad thing? So he never stopped wandering.
You know, my father had wealth all down the
evening.
He was raised a slave. He taught all the kids how to read. A good old fashioned.
Mr. Morgan! Mr. Morgan.
Yes, Reverend.
Do you think the Pinkertons are finally gonna kill us?
Perhaps.
I'm so worried.
He beat the slaves almost.
For the crime of being born, but it's...
You busy, Arthur?
When his sister-in-law, the master's wife, walks in. Now, fearing for my father's life, she told her brother-in-law to stop. Well, not only did he not stop, he beat her, too. Next day, his brother, the master, shot him dead.
The long time, boy. Yeah, that's it, boy. Yeah, nearly done, boy. Okay, boy. Let's go. Yeah.
Let me go. And there's no bad blood.
No bad blood.
There's more than 40 years of bad blood between you and us.
What in Christ's name?
How you like coming up against the Raiders?
What kind of sorry business was this?
Been waiting for you, Arthur.
Well, I'm sorry to have kept you.
Come on, let's get going.
They spoke to Bill about a job needing security.
After the farce of stealing the horses for them, why are we doing this?
Because we need to stay in with them, and they're paying.
So what kind of security they want?
We're about to find out. Now come on.
This seemed legit to you, Bill.
Sure. Dutch said we was to keep on dealing with them until we find this gold.
Can we trust them?
Can we trust anyone?
Yeah. Let's just see what they say.
They said there was some big misunderstanding about them horses.
And what about boarding their fields?
They don't know we had anything to do with that.
Oh, that's so?
Yeah. They think it was the Braithwaites. Listen, I know these Gray Boys a bit now. This is on the level.
We're stuck in the middle of some ancient feud, but instead of playing both sides, we're being used by both of them.
They were saying the Catherine Braithwaite.
Hey, hold up. This don't feel right.
Now it don't feel right? I could have told you.
You okay?
take the front, you take the back. You're gonna walk out of here. Get the front. You take the back. One of these bastards gonna walk out of here. Shit. Real heavy over here, fellas. We got a pack box. We need to get into this store, Morgan.
You want to cross me, do you? I'm gonna hit him from the other side.
Hurry, Arthur! You need to get in there!
You're getting sloppy, Morgan.
You see that window and Sean's skull? Don't talk to me about sloppy.
Better in here, not there.
to come out, we'll come out!
Shit! Oh, Bill!
Guns on the ground, now! Both of you, don't do it!
You know we can't do that. You put the gun down, Sheriff!
I'll blow his brains out!
You want to join your little friend there, do you?
Either way, you're a dead man. Morgan?
A good kid.
Well, how the hell was I to know?
Let me see. They set us up once before. They didn't like us. We destroyed their farm. Should I go on?
Go easy on him, Morgan.
He was out trying to find a lead. Same as you. Same as Hosea. All you do is complain when things don't work out. Except when it's your goddamn fault.
You don't know what you're talking about. You don't give a damn about nobody but yourself.
Oh, you act so high and mighty, but you're no better than the rest of us. I've ridden with you boys close on, what, 6 months now? And all you ever done was complain. You can fight, but you can't think.
You can't do either.
Okay, cowpoke.
Bill, take the boy's body. Bury him proper someplace, quiet. Micah, best you and I don't speak for a moment.
I'm just so frightened by you.
Get out of my sight, pair of fools. Sean has been killed. His head shot half off in an ambush. Still no Confederate gold, but a shitload of trouble.